Okay, so I've got my reel. I've got all the bits and pieces. Now, it's important that you put your reel on your rod correctly because you don't want sort of any corrosion and you don't want any slippage, because rigging up for game fishing is all about doing everything right, little bits of detail. So one of the first things I do, I've got a product here, Lanacote, but any sort of real heavy, high viscosity or very tacky grease will do. And I'm just gonna spread a little bit of that around on the reel seat there. Now, the reason for this is that we've got uncommon metals. So we've got an alloy here, we've got a stainless steel here. So you add salt water to that mix and we're gonna get a lot of corrosion. So to further protect that corrosion, I use a little bit of insulation or electrical tape. Now, on the reel seat, just using a wee little bit of overlap there so it wraps around, actually helps it sit more snugly on the rod as well. What I'm doing is I'm just creating a barrier between the two uncommon metals, sticking that on there. Now, it's quite important you use red tape because it's luckier. And then a little bit more of the Lanacote or grease over the top of that. Now, in essence, we've just created a neutral barrier in between those uncommon metals. We place it in there, jam it on, and we do this up, but don't do it up completely tight right from the outset. Quite often there's a little bit of play. Look down, look across the horizontal level of your bar and make sure that it's level. That guy there's level. So we can now tighten up fully and put on the reel clamp. Okay, so we get all our supplied pieces out of the package here. And the first things to go on, these little numbers here. Now again, I'm just applying a little bit of Lanacote around them. Now these are stainless and they are in stainless, so they're less likely to corrode, but that salty environment, it just takes 2 seconds. I wouldn't really put them in without it. And we're just gonna be locking them in place with the nut that comes supplied. So we're just gonna drop that in there. We turn it to lock and then we just tighten up. So now it's time for our the back of the reel clamp to go on. Now, this has got an attachment point for your safety line. Some people run them upwards. I just reckon it looks dorky. And your safety line hangs nicer when it's pointing down. There's a barcode sticker already on here, so that's actually gonna help keep the foreign metals separated, but I'm gonna add a little bit of red tape as well. And just sort of stick that on there, just to keep that separation. And what you find too with the tape is it actually beds into it and it allows a little bit more grip and less sideways slippage, because of course when you've got a big fish on there can be quite a bit of sideways torque. A little bit of our Lanacote grease on the back of the reel seat there, that sits in place. We've got our screws to go on. Just popping a little bit of grease on the inside there, so as that screws on, that'll spread its way down the thread, and it just means that when it needs to come off, it's not going to be corroded in place. There's a big slot in these screws here, and if you use a screwdriver that's too small, you'll get a little bit of slippage, it'll flick off, and you're going to get a sharp little bird edge, which doesn't really hurt anything, but it doesn't look nice, and this is a nice gear, so we want to keep it nice. Okay, even tension on both sides, so go between the two screws. And just however you finish up, it's really important to make sure that the screws line up, because if they don't, it doesn't look nice.